Hello, our viewers, and we continue to interview people that are being awarded at the Vigoro International Awards Ceremony. We have with us here Nigerian-based actor-producer, Bastel Nkoma. Welcome to Homework TV.
Yeah, Pascal Atoma.
Pascal Atoma.
Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here.
Thanks for coming. So, what do you think award ceremony, such as the Vigoro Award Ceremony, that appreciates and celebrates the unsung heroes is important in our community?
I, even though I'm a director producer, I'm not into awards, right? But this type of awards I support because of what the awards, what they do for the community and for humanity. So that's why I'm supporting Vigoro Awards, because I know that it's all for the to recognize the heroes, people that have done something meaningful in the communities, unlike our business where people get awarded just for making a movie.
Yeah.
So this here, people are not being awarded for making a movie or making a TV series. They are awarded for actually impacting life, humanity. So that's why I like this one. And then in acknowledging those that have done something meaningful to change humanity, those that have impacted the world. So that's what Vigoro Awards is all about, and that's why I like it.
That's amazing. Why do you think there's a lot of people that do amazing things in our community, but nobody recognizes them? Some people like you don't really care to be recognized. They do it to help others. They do it to showcase their passion. But why do you think for some others, because volunteering and all that is important, but sometimes you burn out. Why do you think it's important for them to be recognized?
It's good to encourage people. It's good to appreciate people. It's good, it's like a car driving that is running. It's good to add fuel before it runs out of. So that encouragement, that recognition do help them to keep going and for them to realize that what they're doing is beautiful. But a lot of people like me, I don't really care, because I think it's my job to help whoever I can help. It is our responsibility to help the less privileged. It's our responsibility to impact any community we find ourselves in. If you're from Ghana or you're from Congo and you live in the U.S. in Baltimore, you need to impact that community, because once you can impact that community will help you to impact your community at home. If you live in Toronto, Canada, you need to try to impact Toronto, Canada, because once you do that, the powers that be here will not help you to go and impact your own community. You understand? So that's for me, that's what it is.
Absolutely.
They need to be encouraged.
Yes. Absolutely. So as far as being the African diaspora, whether we come from all parts of Africa, being diverse, why is it important to keep our traditions alive and to help each other, to empower each other living in the West?
It is very important, because keeping the traditions alive brings unity. Because it helps to unite us. You know, just because you live in Canada and you're for many years, yes, we are Canadian citizens, but Canada wants people to bring something new to improve them. It's like when you, it's like going to a job. They're not going to hire you on a job just for you to come get paid. They hire you to bring value to their job. So the people of Canada, they don't know much about African culture. Who is going to bring it to them? You're going to bring your country culture to them. I'm going to bring Nigerian culture to them. So she's going to bring Ghanaian culture. He's going to bring Somalian culture. When we all bring these cultures, then it brings more unity. And then people can now open up minds to see maybe this way your culture is doing it is not the best for humanity. Maybe we should try this culture. I give you an example. In African culture, it is when when an elderly person walks into a room. In African culture, the younger one will rise from the seat, let the elderly person take a seat. That is not Canadian culture. That is not American culture. But we're able to bring it now that I'm seeing a lot of Canadians, a lot of Americans. Now, when you get in a train or somewhere where there's only one seat or two seats, the younger ones are learning that, oh, we need to get up and let them sit.
Absolutely.
Do you understand? Like my daughter also goes to school where when I come to see my daughter, they go, "Hi, Pascal." I say, "No, not Pascal.
Mr.
Pascal." But you see, their culture is "Hi" like that.
Yeah.
And if my daughter come back from school and say, "Hi, Daddy," I say, "No, it's not Hi, Daddy. You come here, you give me a hug, you say, 'Good afternoon, Daddy.'" I say, "Good afternoon, how are you?" Then you say, "Hi." You see, so now when her friends are coming over, she tells them, "Don't call my daddy by name Pascal."
Yeah.
You see that? So that's our culture that we're beginning to teach them. And they are now taking it to their own homes. So that's why it's very, very important.
Very important. So, Mr. Pascal, yes, can you tell me about one of your movies that made it big, one that you recommend our viewers to watch?
Okay, I'm sure that every African in the US, Canada, Australia, London, Africa itself, they have watched My American Nurse before. Mm-hmm. Yeah, My American Nurse is a story about an African going back to Nigeria, Africa, bringing a wife into America just for her to become a nurse, make money, and feed him so that he can relax and chill and go home and get chieftaincy titles. So I'm sure all the viewers out there, you guys have watched American Nurse. Yeah. This is Shehu Shehu.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time. Thank you. Our viewers, stay tuned with us. We're going to definitely go into the ceremony right now. Thank you.